Here's a quick little update video regarding the Sonoff Security Camera. Now, this is not meant for the normal consumer, this is mainly meant for hackers and just reverse engineering guys, just to look into this camera more easily, because you always had to use some wires and solder some wires to the main board in the camera to get access to the shell and everything. But now you can actually get SSH access under this thing, full SSH access. And it's super easy as well. You just have to put a few files on an SD card and 30 seconds later you get access to SSH. This is amazing because now you don't have to open up this thing, mod it, and to solder to such tiny pads on the motherboard itself. And yeah, this was just a little barrier that's now being overcome. So how do you actually get this to work? First, you have to go to my GitHub repo, which I will link down in the description, and download this SSH hack file. Once you've downloaded it, simply unpack it and you'll get one boot.sh file and one folder. Now, all you have to do is take those two, copy them, and simply put them onto an SD card. There we go. And the next thing is super simple. Just plug it in and power the camera on. So here's the SD card. Just put it into the camera. There we go. Now it's in. And just plug it in. Of course, you also have to configure it with the EVLink app first, so it does have network connection.
Please wait for internet connecting. Internet connected. Welcome to use cloud camera.
There we go. Now we have to find out the IP of this camera. And for me, it's pretty simple. I just go into my pfSense box and go to DHCP leases and it should be there. Yeah, IPC. So the next step for me is just to copy this IP address, open putty, whatever you want to call it, paste it in here, and yeah, there we go. Now I can say yes. The standard login is root and SSH hack, I think, and we're in. So yeah, that's basically it. So now you have full access to this camera. Now there are a few restrictions, of course, because it uses rootfs, which I think is read only. And there are some other partitions though that you can write to, but just keep in mind that most of the stuff you do on here is temporary and will not carry over a reboot. So you can use the microSD files to get started and write your own scripts basically, which could lead to a full custom firmware of this thing, which I would be super grateful, because if we take a look here and on the app, of course, and put it to HD. And of course it doesn't work, but of course it doesn't come over on video this well, but this thing is super low quality, so it's not useful for any RTSP streaming or anything else. So yeah, I would love to see a custom firmware with higher bitrate, higher frame rate, and better RTSP implementation basically. So yeah, but this is a first awesome step to get this thing hacked. Thanks for watching, I hope you enjoyed it, and don't forget to leave a like if you like this video, leave a subscribe if you super like this video, and stay up to date with this camera, because it will definitely make more videos about it, since it's a cheap and awesome hardware. So yeah, thanks and have a nice day!